To the correct news. This is Sean Spicer with the Donald Trump administration welcoming you to... What is with the new press secretary for Donald Trump? Welcome to the correct news. I like the man. I'm sure he's like a really good guy. I liked what I could make it through without falling asleep of his speech. I'm not talking anything bad here except for the fact that he is as boring as watching tree bark. Now, I understand he's a press secretary, not an entertainer. I'm not expecting breakdancing up there. But, oh my God, the man was like watching a talking tree. I've never seen... Why didn't he use Katrina? Katrina did amazing for him during all that time. She spoke for him better than he did. She was able to clarify what he... But instead, he asked and spice her. I'm sure he's a good guy. I'm sure. Anyway, welcome aboard, friends of the correct news. You could tell what I was watching before I took on the show. What do you guys think? What do you guys like of the new setup? How do you guys like the way the show is going? I want to let everybody know you can follow me now at the Conservative Daily Post. I'm actually a journalist, and that's what I do every day for the most part now. So make sure you check me out there at the Conservative Daily Post, where I am posting most often. Trump considers... What's he considering here? This is from Breitbart, and this is really, really good news. Proposals for cutting UN funding. Now, why, you say, Sam, would you want us out of the United Nations? Let me ask you, dear listener, why would you want us in? Don't you know that Agenda 21 is going to limit where you can drive, how you can drive, if you can drive, and what kind of car you may drive when you do it? They want to force everyone into apartments that are not much bigger than the studio that I'm in now. That includes the bathroom in some instances. They have signed the world up for a lot of dreadful anti-West deals. A lot of them are anti-West, and they are pro-Islamic, which is not a problem. It is just sometimes mutually exclusive to the West. Do I think we should be bombing each other and killing each other? No. But I do very much think that the cultures need to be somewhat separated. This idea of forced multiculturalism is not a good idea. If someone wants to come over and they're Islamic, then they need to respect the culture that they're coming into. And if they want to have their own culture, they may be more than welcome to do so, but they cannot force the rest of the country to do so just because their religion says that the world must be Islamified, which is what the Quran says. At least according to the way that a lot of them read it. Some people think it means that the message is to go everywhere, not the force of the religion. Well, I hate to tell you, but so far it has been the force of the religion. Why do you think Egypt doesn't worship Ra anymore? How do you think that happened? They didn't choose to do it. It happened by the sword. People miss that. So, of course, maybe we should do something where if you don't really enjoy the culture that you're coming into much, then maybe you shouldn't stay here. That doesn't mean that we can't do peaceful business with you. That doesn't mean that we have to be killing each other. But we're just saying, hey, you're not gonna like it here. Like me. I absolutely detest radio hip-hop. I mean, I cannot stand it. I love artists like Steve Grant, but can't stand like Usher, T-Pain, T.I., or Marion, Rihanna, Beyonce, Weeknd. Oh my God, The Weeknd makes me want to kick a kitten through a house fan. If I happen to go to this club, a friend might say, Sam, go, but you're just not gonna like it. That is what we need to be telling a lot of the people that are coming to the country. You're not going to like it here. By the same token, if I fly to Iran, when I land on Iran's soil, I'm not going to wear a hijab. I'm not going to capitulate to every Islamic demand. but I probably won't go ahead and run the show from their country because I am in their country. It is their country. They have the right to throw my ass out. Now, they'd probably cut my head off. I don't think they have the right to that. But they'd have the right to say, get out. Because it's their country. I don't have... I have God-given rights, but they're not honored there. And when I touch down on the soil, they never promised me that they would be. Do you see where I'm getting here? So these are just some of the reasons why Mr. Trump could very likely... No teleprompter. Get us out of some of this. Listen, the New York Times reports President Trump is looking at proposals for reducing UN funding for the United Nations and scaling back UN influence over American foreign policy. The first of the two draft orders entitled Auditing and Reducing U.S. Funding of International Organizations was obtained by the New York Times. Calls for terminating funding for any United Nations agency or other international body that meets any of the following several criteria. These include organizations that give full membership to the Palestinian Authority or Palestinian Liberation Organization. Why? Because they have refused to acknowledge the acceptance of the State of Israel, and because they have gone so far as to try to dictate to America where we may and may not put an embassy. So they claim they're going to share Jerusalem, but yet America can't have an embassy there. So you're not doing a very good job of sharing. So no, we should not fund them. We should not fund anyone that supports programs that fund abortion. You know what? I'm not completely... I wrote an article about this at the Conservative Daily Post. I'm not as pro-life as some people are. I don't have a problem with it as long as the government isn't paying for it. And I don't want to see any talk of third trimester. I'm sorry. And the government does not have to pay it. It's a dollar to get a condom. I mean, it's not that hard. Buy a condom. Because, again, it's not the government's role. Now, if you want to do it at the state level, you could argue that that's a state issue. If states want to vote themselves into free abortions, they may do so. Not the federal government. Not funding any activity that circumvents sanctions against Iran or North Korea. So North Korea running around the globe with news broadcasts, I should say, threatening the America. Iran chanting death to America in the streets. Well, let me tell you what, Iran. We do most certainly honor your right to free speech. We do. And you may chant death to America anytime you want. And your leader may stand there and condone it and do nothing to stop it any time that he wants. But we're not sending you any money, you turban-headed bastard. This is ridiculous. Why would you send money to somebody that shouts and chanting death to you? Trump is so close-minded. Yeah, he's just off the deep end here, isn't he? The draft order also calls for terminating funding for any organization that is controlled or substantially influenced by any state that sponsors terrorism. So we're no longer going to pay for terrorists under Trump? How misguided he truly is. Also, nobody that is blamed for persecution of marginalized groups or any systemic violation of human rights. Now, see, you don't hear the lefty whinies. You should be hating minorities. No, he doesn't. He just did more to help minorities, particularly poor minorities, in crap hole countries than any president's done in the last 10 years. Why is it, maybe longer than that, why is it that all of our presidents will not stand up against the human rights abuses that are going on in other countries? I can tell you why. Because our country wants to send our jobs there and make those poor slaves make our iPhones and our touch screens and all of that so that we don't have to pay American workers fair wages because the companies move it out of seas, get it made in another country, and then charge you as much as they would have here if they weren't completely gouging the money supply of the company. So due to that, they allow every kind of rotten, backstabbing, mentally and physically and sexually abusing kind of slavery in the world just to get their iPhones made cheaply. Well, Trump is putting an end to NATO and many of the things that lead to that. And he's standing up for the marginalized groups, it says, and those of systemic violation of human rights. In other words, legalized. The order calls for then enacting at least 40% of all of overall decrease in remaining United States funding towards international organizations. That's wonderful. I'm sorry, that is absolutely why we elected the man, and I am thrilled. Absolutely thrilled. Come on, they're trying to tell us whether or not we can have a Second Amendment. It's none of their damn business. We are a sovereign nation. We are not a state within the New World Order that must answer to everything that they want. And I'm glad to see that those days are quickly coming to an end. I really am. I just watched before I went live. Do you realize the news is saying that Donald Trump has cut in half the number of refugees being allowed into the country? Well, that sounds like a great deal of people, like a huge number of people, until you realize that they wanted to let 100,000 people into the country that are refugees. Now, how in the world do we have the infrastructure or the know-how to vet 100,000 people coming from a foreign nations that have pledged to kill us? How can we tell that all 100,000 of them aren't coming here to create a lot of horrible problems for us, and that also aren't going to be so disrespectful or ignorant, either or both, of the society to bring apart the kinds of things that we have seen at Carnival in Germany, or the gropings in Germany, the rapes in Sweden? Do you realize that Sweden is the rape capital of the world, when they were historically one of the most peaceful non-crime places ever? They don't even know how to handle all these rapes. They really don't have a huge rape problem, well, they do now, in Sweden. You've got the German TV making TV shows that show Muslim, beautiful little petite Muslim girls being raped by great big white German guys, even though that's never happened. There's like nothing on the law books, nothing on the court records that show that it ever happened at all. They could stop politically correct to write it the other way around. All right, friends, moving on. PrisonPlanet.com. Mysterious booms heard around San Diego County. Now, the reason I say mysterious booms is because if you've watched Paul Joseph Wilson, if you've watched him report on these, he refers to them as the mysterious booms. And from this day forward, now, booms will be like a two-syllable word for you. More and more listeners, welcome aboard. I have written about this on BlastingNews.com. Look up BlastingNews.com/... mysterious booms. It's a New Year's Eve. You'll find it right away. Maybe I'll even look it up and screen share it with you. Well, it's happened again. It happened on my birthday, no less. I'm infatuated with booms, and it happened on the 25th. San Diego, several people reported hearing two large bangs and felt the... a bang! You can't... A bang doesn't sound like a boom. Bangs and felt the earth shake just after 3 p.m. Tuesday. This was in San Diego. Some people are saying that this is just the city noises or whatever, which a lot of times these are. The way that you can tell that they may not be is when a lot of calls come in and they don't know what causes it. It says, was there an earthquake that made the big boom at 3:15 p.m.? Nancy Whitaker posted on Facebook. Santee residents reported seeing a large glowing ball in the western sky. So this might not be one of the more mysterious of the booms we have. However, all jokes aside, some people, you know, we get aliens and all that, but a lot of people have said that there are suspicions about whether or not this could be the government testing a weapon. And people said that it wouldn't, you know, I've always said it wouldn't, isn't something that would be done on New Year's Eve. It's something that would be done on the 4th of July if you were trying to hide it. Unless, of course, you were somehow testing it on the residents. Well, I automatically thought it was an earthquake. My car started moving back and forth in Imperial Beach, Laura Reynolds said. Somebody else asked if they had an earthquake. I heard it on the Strand and I didn't feel anything. It sounded like two loud bangs. I thought it was thunder. I'm curious what it could have been. And USGS did not detect an earthquake in San Diego during the time. Fox reached out to military officials and law enforcement to see if they had anything to do with the strange reports, and they were told that they aren't weather related. They did not detect an earthquake, and the FAA public affairs manager was checking with the military, and they reviewed all tapes with the FAA and was confident that it wasn't caused by an aircraft either. This is the this is more people reporting here about what it could. So it wasn't an airplane. It wasn't anything the military admittedly did. More mysterious booms, and I'm going to go to this one real quick just so that you can look it up if you want to. This has been going on for a number of years. If you don't know, the booms usually happen on the 4th of July, though it's certainly not limited to that. And they're always ruled out as being something. If a plane flies overhead and you hear a sonic boom, that's not what these people are talking about. If there is an earthquake, or there, if you live near a steel mill or steel mill or something, that's not what they're talking about. They're speaking specifically about unexplained, confirmed unexplained. And we're seeing more and more of these. People have said that it could be tunneling under the earth. Point is, nobody has any idea whatsoever what it is. So if you guys, if anyone around me would know, let me know, particularly in the cities of Ohio. Because I haven't heard about this happening in Ohio, but I have heard about it happening a lot in most other states. And I'm pretty sure that it would be reported quite widely if it started to happen here. And they would be able to mask such a thing, though, due to things like the Timken Company and that. So if they're testing something, my point being, why wouldn't they test it in areas where the booms would blend right in? So perhaps it's something that isn't necessarily government related in the way that we're normally thinking of it. Because if it was, then there would probably be more ways to mask it and to hide it than what they're doing. Unless it's something that needs to be done on an ocean, which is interesting, because we do know that various parts of the ocean are somewhat hollow. So, alright friends, there you go. Blasting news, head to it. Arctic expeditions confirm no global warming. I know, nobody wants to hear about the mysterious booms. You want to hear about all the political killing each other in the world. Well, I do have something political about how Al Gore and many people of his ilk have been saying the global warming monster is coming to get you. Well, let me tell you what. The global warming monster has proved to be just about as real as the one-eyed, half-winged tooth fairy at this point. And we have another story proving that man is not warming the planet. Arctic expeditions confirm no global warming. Sea ice extent nearly same as 100 years ago. Kit writes, there is no such thing as man-made global warming drastically melting ice in the Antarctic, according to analysis of Antarctic expeditions over the past 100 years. When the current sea ice extent in Antarctica is superimposed over past routes of expedition ships, it reveals that the ice on the frigid continent is largely the same now as it was in the early 20th century, long before coal plants took off to a huge degree. Now, what does that mean? It means that, let's take this alien since John Hurt died. We'll get to that in a minute. If this here is the, rest in peace, my friend, if this here is the continent, you would go around it like this. The reason you would do that is because, you know, the ice, it's where the beach would be if it wasn't ice. It's the end of the glacier line. Okay. Now, if it was shrinking over time, and this is why you tune in, if it was shrinking over time, then this here would be in further, all of this would be in, and you would actually be traversing way inward. So when you incorporated the two maps, you would see that this one here is much smaller than this one here because it has melted over the years. Well, that's not what has happened. Why? Because we are not warming the planet, and Antarctica is not melting. That is why. Shazam, Sparky. This is a revolutionary revelation, given that man-made climate change advocates are constantly citing Antarctica as evidence of global warming. Guess what? There is no evidence of global warming on their main bit of proof. This further demonstrates that the global warming created by man is just a fraud to get more taxes, reported Zero Hedge correctly. Scientists have looked over the logbooks of polar explorers Robert Falcon Scott and Ernest Stapleton from their expeditions during 1901 through 1904 and 1907 through 1909. Now keep in mind, there weren't a whole plethora of factories operating in 1901. For those of you that don't know, there were virtually none. The theory that sea ice has declined post-1950 because of man cannot be supported. Even the Telegraph, an established media outlet, admitted the past expeditions indicate changes in sea ice are part of a natural cycle and not an OT, not the result of man-made global warming. We know that sea ice in the Antarctic has increased slightly over the past 30 years since satellite observations began, which is another way they can tell that it's not happening. Superimpose those together. As well, you know, with the 1901. Dr. Jonathan Day, a meteorology professor who studied the data, scientists have been grappling to understand this trend in the context of global warming. Well, you know what? Maybe these findings suggest maybe anything new. Maybe you need to stop trying. That's like saying I'm trying to understand how a fish works through the eyes of a talking butterfly. There are no talking butterflies, and they have nothing to do with fish. So you will never understand fish by looking through it through the prism of a talking butterfly. You will never be able to understand why the ice isn't going anywhere when you're looking through it through the prism of global warming, because the ice isn't going anywhere because global warming isn't happening, you stupid... Oh my God! How does this kind of stupidity even make... How does this guy get a doctor? When he get a doctor, with a Cracker Jack box, did he open it up and it just popped out at him like a jack-in-the-box? What the hell? If ice levels were as low a century ago, as estimated in this research, then a similar increase may have occurred between then and the middle of the century, when previous studies suggest ice levels were higher. Additionally, the sun is reaching its lowest activity. It was very high, so we warm. Guess what? It's down low, so guess what? We're getting cold. It's at its lowest activity since 2011, which is fueling concerns the Earth could enter a mini ice age, which I also don't believe. The longest... Maybe we should tax the sun if that happens. You know, our heating bills will be higher, so I'm sure he'll pay his global cooling tax there, the great sun. The longest minimum on record, the Maronal Millennium of 1645 to 1715, lasted an incredible 70 years. And needless to say, friends, we are not warming the planet. Guys, I got two more stories to get to. Before I do, I want you to do me a favor and just spend a while. I can figure out how my own computer works. Spend just one moment looking at this. It's the day the lights went out. It's the book by D. Allen Ross that is hilarious. Remember The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy before the movie ruined it? Okay, that's what this is like. It's really, really funny, and that's hard to capture in a book. But he does so. So please check it out, D. Allen Ross, The Day the Lights Went Out. This was just too fun. I was going through things throughout the year that I did not cover, and I'm only going to spend about 30 seconds on this, but it was too funny to not cover, and I don't know how it didn't get covered. I was cleaning out my bookmarks, and it was in the wrong folder, yada yada. ClickOrlando.com, I guess I do know. Santa at Sanford Mall replaced for saying that Hillary Clinton was on the naughty list. Now, this is dated in November, but it was just too funny to not get to. The mother of town center management brought the incident Tuesday night when she thought two of her children to see Santa. When the 10-year-old daughter told him she wanted for Christmas, he told her she was on the nice list. She then asked her, "Do you know who is on the naughty list?" "Hillary Clinton." The girl said he then laughed. The girl's mother called management, blah, 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 blah. You know what? That's a Santa hero right there. I'm just very, very proud of that Santa. May God bless him. And that brings us, friends, to the dumb D of the day. Oh, yes. Dumb D of the day. You guys know that the Dunce Cap of the Month Award. The Dunce Cap of the Month Award is actually going to be happening within mere days. It's going to be next week. But as we build up to the Dunce Cap of the Month Award, we do have the Dummy of the Day every day. And here's what it is. I'm going to say before I go into it that I want to be just a little bit lenient on this individual because I'm a snowboarder and I like to try things new all the time. There's video of me, look up Ollie Wins Sam the Gangi, where I do relatively well for an amateur novice, but I'm one injury away. Okay, I get it. Well, this guy is taking it to the next level. This gentleman, and we're going to watch the video, jumped from a roof of a hotel room, landed on concrete with both feet from it looks to be at least a 7 or 8 story jump, and is now using a GoFundMe page to pay for his medical bills. I can't be very hard on this guy, but I mean, let's face it, his insurance isn't going to cover it. They should, but his insurance isn't going to cover it, and he's looking for help to pay for it. I may actually give the guy $1, even though I'm giving him the dummy of the day. You'll see why. I'm torn on this guy. I really am. A man known for his thrill-seeking jumps now is in the hospital with two shattered feet. Ow! After missing his mark, we will watch it after this. At the Laguna Hotel pool, and is asking the public for help to pay for his medical bills. Now, the only reason I think that he could ever be entertained as a reason to help pay for this dummy is because it's part of his page. He is a daredevil. But it's illegal. I'm sure it's not legal to jump from buildings, but if he's not harming anybody but himself, there's nobody in the pool, he's not landing on anyone. He probably doesn't have the money to get the permits. Evil can do it, you know, when you get Pepsi sponsors, whatever. I'm just throwing a name out there. I don't know who's sponsoring. Yeah, you can get it done. But Joe Schmo can't. And I know what that's like, because I'm Joe Schmo doing a political show. And I'm asking you guys to fund me, which is a lot like jumping off a roof. But here's what I'm saying. You gotta kind of be lenient towards the guy. It's his page. It's what he does for a living. It must not be paying very well, but then again, I imagine two broken feet are quite expensive. Anthony Booth, Armor, 28, is laid up in the hospital, and he wears like a bandana over his face, even though his name is in it, which is even sillier. Then again, he probably just doesn't want it on TV so that everybody can ask him about it all day. Is laid up in the hospital for the next 4 weeks, has casts on both feet, and expects two more surgeries. He says he is feeling all sorts of pain, but not regret. So, I mean, he at least does have cojones. It's super painful, Armor said. They took the wrapper off yesterday, and I was in shock, almost. All right, so let's take a real quick look. He said he's itching to do something. It's no joke. The Daredevil YouTube sensation has taken a lot of heat on social media for his GoFundMe page, raising money for his medical bills that his insurance won't cover. You know what? What, do we want no more daredevils in the world? We've already ruined the Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey Circus, which was an American institution. Do we want to take it the next step and make it so that we have no fun at all left in the country? Is that really what we want? We want no daredevils. We want no people that really push the envelope for entertainment. Yeah, I don't want the guy to die. I'm not encouraging him to do it, but if he wants to do it, well, I mean, I'm not saying die for my enjoyment, but he's the one who wants to do it. Let's take a look at this as it loads here, friends. Rather disturbing, to say the least. While this loads, let me remind you, you can donate at correctviews@hotmail.com, where every penny that you give to me goes towards a better show. And as this loads, this is I'm warning you, this is painful. Christelle, could you do me a favor and zoom in on the actual TV screen here? This, friends, is more than mildly painful. All right, you got it? Here she comes. Yeah, she's just laughing because this is going to hurt, Christelle. Wait, get the TV in and let me know when you're on it. Rest of you, get your popcorn. As she, I have two cameras running for those of you on the lowdown. You got it? They can't hear you shake your head now. I sound like I'm talking to myself.
No.
Oh, no, that's still being normal. All right, she sounds thrilled, doesn't she? Alright, I was wrong, it's not 10 stories, it's only 3 or 4, it looked like it from the top angle, I stand corrected. It's still enough to not do you any good. Alright, watch it, here we go, you ready? Here we go. Watch this. From choice, in theory. No, it won't play. Look at this! Here it is. Here's the other angle. Feet. See that mark right there, friends? That's his feet. That's the mark of his feet. Yeah. Ow. We're going to go ahead and stay with this here. Look, yeah, I mean, he's kicking his feet. I don't know how you could kick your feet after that. I do not know. He took the jump there. It says at 8:19. I'm talking about the leap of faith. There's one that shows it from the top angle, too, and I don't know where it is, but there it is. Look at this. Look at this. This is insane. Christelle has stepped out for the first two. Too Swedish. Get ready, Frey. It's worth the wait. I put it at the end so nobody can say I have a bad show. But watch this.
Oh, someone will still say you have a bad show.
And maybe liking this makes it a bad show. I don't know. It's just crazy. I'm going to donate to the guy just because he's got cojones. At least if I remember. Phone calls not take this long. I don't want to skip ahead because it's only got 30 seconds, so how long does it be? I'm glad I put it at the end of the show. I know what you're wearing. I like your legs. I have a phone call for you. Here we go. There he is. So you know what, I think I am going to donate to the crazy bastard, but let me tell you what, friends, not only should you not do this at home, it'd probably be very hard for you to do this at home unless you live in a 3-story hotel, but just in case, not only should you not do this at home, but if you do, you will be lucky if the only thing that you do is break your feet. Good night, friends. God bless. Please donate at correctviews@hotmail.com. Every penny you give to me goes towards a better show. You can do that through PayPal. Hit subscribe and hit share. Good night. God bless.